My Jesus knows my name. When I'm sleeping or awake, no matter what I do, He'll never leave, His words are true. I tell Him what I love. I tell Him when I'm scared. I tell Him everything. Jesus is always there. I'm spinning round, I'm running free. I'm having fun, yeah, with my King. No one is like You, Jesus. No one like You. Really bad days, You are strong. When it's good, You laugh along. My best friend, my BFF, Jesus, that's You. My Jesus knows my name. When I'm sleeping or awake, no matter what I do, He'll never leave, His words are true. I tell Him what I love. I tell Him when I am scared. I tell Him everything. Jesus is always there. I'm spinning round, I'm running free. I'm having fun, yeah, with my King. No one is like You, Jesus. No one like You. Really bad days, You are strong. When it's good, You laugh along. My best friend, my BFF, Jesus, that's You. Best friends forever, BFF. Best friends forever, BFF. Best friends forever, my BFF, that's You. Best friends forever, BFF. Best friends forever, BFF. Best friends forever, my BFF, that's You. Spinning round, I'm running free. I'm having fun, yeah, with my King. No one is like You, Jesus. No one like You. Really bad days, You are strong. When it's good, You laugh along. My best friend, my BFF, Jesus, that's You. My best friend, my BFF, Jesus, that's You. My best friend, my BFF, Jesus, that's You.
God's story, the good news. So part of God's story is about the gospel or the good news. And it goes like this. In the beginning, God made everything. The sun, the moon, stars, planets, the entire galaxy. And Earth was part of that creation. God made mountains and oceans and forests and deserts and animals that crawled on the ground and flew in the air and swam in the water. Then He made people. Adam and Eve, to live in a garden called Eden. And God called everything He had made good. There was just one rule. Adam and Eve could eat anything they wanted except for the fruit from this one tree. But a snake tricked Adam and Eve into disobeying that one rule. Because of that, sickness, sadness, and all kinds of bad things came into God's perfect creation. All because people made wrong choices. Part of how God punished Adam and Eve was by not allowing them in the perfect garden anymore. And if that were the end of the story, that would be bad news for us. That would mean all the wrong stuff in the world would never be made right. But God still loved people, and He had good news for them. He was going to send a rescuer. So they waited, and waited, and waited. Then one day, the rescuer was born as a baby named Jesus. Christmas is when we celebrate the good news of Jesus being born. But it's not just that He was born, it's what He did later that was the best news of all. He took the punishment for all the wrong choices that anyone has ever made anywhere. See, all of us have continued to make wrong choices, just like Adam and Eve did. And just like Adam and Eve, we deserve to be punished for our wrong choices. But here's the thing, Jesus the Rescuer never made a single bad choice. Kids, think about a time you made a bad choice. Maybe telling a lie, or taking something that wasn't yours, or hurting another person with something you did or said. Can you believe that whatever that was, Jesus never made a choice like that? And even though he never made a bad choice, he still took the punishment for our wrong choices? And then Jesus did something even more completely unexpected. He came back to life. Really? You can read about it in the Bible, in the stories written by Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. We call those books Gospels, which is just an old fancy word for, you guessed it, the good news of Jesus coming to earth, dying for our wrong choices, and coming back to life. That's what we celebrate on Easter. But not just because coming back to life is totally amazing. By coming back to life, Jesus was showing that God can make anything new. There's nothing God can't do. He's more powerful than any sadness, shame, wrong choice, disease, disaster, and even death. And that's the best, most amazing good news of all. It's so amazing, Jesus' friends told everyone they could find about the good news. And those people told other people. And those people told other people. And on and on. And that's still happening today. In fact, you just heard the good news, and the Bible says, if you openly declare that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. That's another way to say God rescues us. And that rescue includes you, your friends, your family, and anyone else in the whole world. And that's the story of the good news. So, in case you missed it, here's the quick version. God made a perfect world. People made mistakes and the world isn't perfect anymore. God promised his family a rescuer. The rescuer's name is Jesus. Jesus died to take a punishment we deserve, but he didn't stay dead. Jesus came back to life because Jesus can make anything new. And that's a part of God's story.
同学们，你们长大以后想做什么工作呢？我要当律师。为什么呢？因为外婆说可以赚很多钱。<笑>我要做工程师，因为妈妈说我的数学很好。<笑>
他常常照顾那些很孤单、被别人欺负的学生们，关心他们，安慰他们。有一次，我跑太快跌倒了，很痛，很害怕，是炮叔叔把我扶起来，带我到保健室，还为我祷告，让我心里有平安。嗯，所以你也想要跟他一样吗？嗯，是的。
我也想要帮助身边有需要的人，像耶稣一样，让身边的人都有喜乐和平安。很好，神创造我们的时候都有美好的计划，他对我们每一个人的心意都是独特的哦。所以，不论你们长大以后会做什么工作，经历什么事情，我们都要活出耶稣的样式，尽力做好自己哦。嗯，我们知道了。
我们每一个人的生命都有神美好的命定，无论我们的职业是什么，都要尽力来荣耀神哦。以弗所书1章18到19节，并且照明你们心中的眼睛，使你们知道他的恩召有何等指望，他在圣徒中得的基业有何等丰盛的荣耀。
Ephesians chapter 1, verses 18 through 19. I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know the hope to which he has called you, the riches of his glorious inheritance in his holy people, and his incomparably great power for us who believe.
小岔路，每个年日你都比救赎。
在基督里一切旧事都变新，谎言定罪不能拦阻我前进，一生经营跟随与主，我注定带领我必走在神美好的命定。你已拣选我，
俄巴底亚书，这是旧约中最短的一卷书，只有21节。刚开始阅读时会感觉这卷书好像毫无盼望，里面包含了一系列神审判古代以东人的诗歌。以东是古代以色列的邻国，中间隔着死海，然而书中的信息远不止这些。先来看看故事的背景。以东人的身份很特别，他们曾和以色列共有一位祖先，同属于亚伯拉罕家族。亚伯拉罕和撒拉生了以撒，以撒和利百加生了雅各和以扫。创世纪讲述了两兄弟的故事，描述了他们之间的紧张关系。他们分别被取名为以色列和以东，人们也这样称呼他们各自的后裔。这两个家族延续了祖先之间的关系。几百年过去，以色列和以东一直关系紧张，但他们仍然有血缘关系。当耶路撒冷被巴比伦攻陷之后，以东背叛了以色列，并与他断绝了关系。当以色列遭到巴比伦的入侵和攻占时，以东人竟然趁机掠夺以色列其他的城市，抓捕甚至杀害以色列难民。在其他的先知书中，神要以色列的邻国为这种暴力付上代价，所以俄巴底亚先知对以东的预言也是这样。这卷书很短，包括两个部分。前半部分是对以东领袖的控告，特别针对他们的狂傲和自大。他们住在沙漠高处的岩洞中，自认为比以色列人更优越。当巴比伦攻击耶路撒冷时，骄傲的以东人不仅不出手相助，甚至还一起攻击。所以神透过俄巴底亚先知说，以东怎样对待以色列，他们也会被怎样对待。有一天，以东会从高位上被拉下来，最终被消灭。正当我们以为会听到更多关于以东的消息时，书卷忽然在第15节改变主题，宣告说耶和华降罚的日子临近万国。为什么话题忽然从以东转向万国了呢？这一节是一个转折点，它将前后两部分连接起来。俄巴底亚宣称耶和华的日子不仅会临到以东，其焦点更会扩大到列国。俄巴底亚说，所有像以东那样狂傲的国家都将面临神的审判，他们会从高位上跌下来并被毁灭。以东和万国这两部分相联合，向我们展示了俄巴底亚先知为什么会对以色列南边那个小小的邻国感兴趣。俄巴底亚把以东的骄傲和没落作为一个例子，表明神有一天也会对付万国的骄傲，使他们没落。在希伯来文中，以东这个词和人类这个词的拼写完全一样。在俄巴底亚书中，以东的兴衰和没落象征着神会在耶和华的日子临到时审判万国的骄傲和暴力。但正如所有先知书所宣告的，神的审判从来都不是最终的结局。俄巴底亚书、约珥书和阿摩斯书都提到了这一点。约珥先知描绘了耶和华的日子临到万国后会发生的事，他说神会在耶路撒冷施行新的拯救，凡谦卑求告耶和华名的就必得救。在阿摩斯书的结尾，阿摩斯先知说，在耶和华的日子临到并审判以色列的罪之后，神会兴起大卫家，为以色列建立新的国，当中包含以东以及所有称为我名下的国。 所以俄巴底亚书被放在约珥书和阿摩斯书后面，是为了让神国临到万国的盼望继续延伸。这卷书以一个蛮有盼望的未来作为结尾，神说他会在新耶路撒冷重建他的国，其中居住着他忠心的渔民，而神的国会扩展到以色列周围的领土和国家。这卷短小的书卷也描写了其他先知书中曾出现的神的公义和信实。以东人在历史中的骄傲和悖逆反映了整个人类的境况，涉及到人类彼此的背叛、互相伤害和对神创造的美好世界的破坏。但人类仍然有盼望。俄巴底亚先知说，以东的衰败指向了未来的某一天，神会对付这个世界的罪，并让充满平安和医治大能的国度临到万国。这就是俄巴底亚书的经意。
以赛亚书中有一首优美的诗，
耶路撒冷城刚刚被北方的大帝国巴比伦毁灭，几乎所有的犹太人都被流放到国外，只有极少数人仍留在城里。他们想知道究竟发生了什么，我们的神抛弃我们了吗？
对，本来耶路撒冷应该是一座属神的城，神在此统管世界，为所有人带来和平和祝福。
以赛亚说，耶路撒冷的毁灭是以色列人应得的，因为他们背离了自己的神，败坏了德行，所以他们的城和圣殿都被毁了。
似乎一切都失去了。
但这首诗没有在此结束，城墙上站着一个守望的人，从山上很远的地方会看见一位信使，他正朝城中跑来，一边跑一边喊：好消息！以赛亚说，那报佳音的，这人的脚登山何等佳美。
美丽的脚？
对啊，这人的脚是美的，因为他们带来了美好的信息。
这是什么意思呢？
这是说，尽管耶路撒冷被摧毁，以色列的神仍然掌权，有一天神将亲自回到这座城，登上宝座，并带来和平。
守望的人高兴地欢呼起来，因为他们的神仍在作王。
我们在新约中找到了同一个短语，好消息，就是希腊语的 euangelion， 这个词有时也翻译成福音。
所以当基督徒问你相信福音吗，他们的意思是你相信这个好消息吗？
这指的可不是一般的消息。在圣经中，这个词一直用来宣告新王登基。在新约中，福音书用这个词来概括耶稣的所有教导，他们说他去宣扬神国的好消息。
因此耶稣把自己看作是传扬这个消息的使者，神在掌权。
是的，但他描述神掌权的方式让每个人都很惊讶。通常人们认为一个强大成功的王国必须强盛，能够强制推行他的意志，能够打败敌人。但耶稣说，神国里最伟大的人是最软弱的人，是付出爱的人，是为穷人服务的人。他说，当你对待罪恶的态度是爱你的敌人，宽恕他们，并寻求和平时，你就生活在神的统治之下。这样的国度与世上的国度截然相反。
耶稣又说，他把神的国带到了世上。
是的，举个例子，一位罗马高级官员来找耶稣，求耶稣医治他的仆人，他甚至称耶稣为主，承认耶稣的权柄。耶稣称赞这个人，因为他认识到其他人还没有认识到的事。耶稣不仅是宣告神国降临的信使，他还是这个国的王。
于是一个消息传开了，说这位来自加利利的犹太人宣称自己是以色列的王，并像君王一样行事。他指定了十二个门徒，这象征着以色列十二个支派。他医治人，宽恕人的罪。
所有这些都威胁到以色列的领袖，他们最终决定除掉他。耶稣却任凭他们这样做。
如果你想做王，这真是一件不可思议的事。
没错，但对耶稣来说，这是必须发生的。在耶稣眼中，他的子民以色列人所犯的罪和造成的毁坏，只反映了全体人类的处境。所有人都背叛了神，导致整个世界陷入悲惨和毁坏。那么神要如何在这样的世界上实现他的统治呢？耶稣相信，要通过对他的敌人付出牺牲的爱。这就是为什么在福音书中，耶稣受难时，他被描述为犹太人的王。
是，他得到了一顶王冠，他也收到了一件长袍。
他被高举，不是在宝座上，而是在十字架上。
传福音报喜讯的人，他的脚踪何等佳美。
现在好消息是，耶稣已经战胜了死亡， 他作王掌权，他已经亲自除去了我们的罪恶和败坏，他用自己的生命和爱战胜了罪。
然后耶稣差派他的跟随者出去，继续传扬这个颠覆了世界秩序的天国的好消息，
并邀请每个人委身于这位用爱战胜死的君王。
我们在天上的父，愿人都尊你的名为圣，愿你的国降临，愿你的旨意行在地上，如同行在天上。我们日用的饮食，今日赐给我们，免我们的债，如同我们免了人的债，不叫我们遇见试探，救我们脱离凶恶。因为国度、权柄、荣耀，全是你的，直到永远。阿们。
用你大能的宝血遮盖我，开启我心灵，得着我生命，在你宝血里我就得洁净。耶稣求你进入我的心，用你大能的宝血释放我，进入你同在，领受你的爱，在你宝血里我献上敬拜，领我到你宝血里面，所有罪恶你的赦免，更新我生命，在你爱的宝血里面，领我到你宝血里面，领受丰盛奇妙恩典，更新我生命，在你爱的宝血里面。
领我到你宝血里面， 免，所有罪恶必得赦免，更新我生命，在你爱的宝血里面，领我到你宝血里面，领受丰盛奇妙恩典，更新我生命，在你爱的宝血里面。
常常喜乐向主高歌，无论环境如何，高山或低谷主都看顾，相信就能蒙福。常常祷告耐心等候，主做事有定时，流泪撒种必欢呼收割，相信就有喜乐。下垂的手再一次举起来，封闭的心再一次敞开，抛开一切忧虑，放下一切重担，来到主的面前，我喜乐满怀。冰冷的心被主爱来温暖，干渴的灵被主爱充满，主是我的力量，主是我的高台，死
我的呼求。 每当你在各样患难中灰心丧胆的时候，要记得你的神他认识你，他也能够进入你生活每个细节中帮助你，所以要重新抬起头来仰望你的神，因为他仍然是你四维的盾牌，是你的荣耀。你要大声来宣告，你就能够经历他应许的得胜。
我要抬起我的头，仰望主耶稣基督，荣耀君王，我四维的盾牌。我要抬起我的头，高唱哈利路亚，大声宣告，一生靠主的神。大声宣告，一生。
Thank you.
充满。